extremely bright. So I'm very delighted to be here and humbled. And actually, we are having very good senior devotees today speaking. So we all are just trying to little bit fill up the gap which we have due to the absence of Radhesham Prabhu today physically with us. But Radhesham Prabhu's heart must be there with all of us only. And we cannot properly begin without thanking him for all the Utkarsha camps till now and this year especially. He has totally invested his heart into this Utkarsha camps and all the youth camps for his entire life. And today we'll just try to assist him a little bit by sharing what we have heard from him. So if at all there will be some credit in all six of our presentations, today three and tomorrow three, that will be due to His Grace Radhesham Prabhu and Srila Prabhupada. So very soon, after 15 to 20 minutes, we'll switch over to His Grace Mukunda Anand Prabhu and His Grace Hare Krishna Anand Prabhu. They are our worshipable seniors. And before that, I'll just share with you a little introduction to the topic today, and as well as the discussion on fame, one of the opulences of Krishna. So I guess I should begin with the prayers. Om Agyan Dimirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Melitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadhavaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Ramscha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Itinamine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschati Deshatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gautushe Nama He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Bhyashta Krupa Sindhu Bhya Evacha Patita Nama Pavane Bhyo Vaishnavi Bhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shrivas Adi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So please forgive me for my not so good throat. Thanks to the wonderful festivals we had last 2 days. We had so much, 11, 12 hours of singing kirtans and bhajans. So throat has taken a back seat. So we are here for discussing a very wonderful topic. What is it? The topic is six opulences of Krishna. Shad Aishwarya Krishna. What is this topic all about? See, right from our childhood, we would have experienced getting attracted to some heroes, having some ideals, having some magnetic personalities whom we just think about all day, or we just get attracted to. And the entire Indian social phenomena is that the parents, right from the early childhood, show us so many heroes in our life to be attracted to, right? Like, for example, I remember when we were little kids, so the parents would say that, oh, this, look at this, your neighboring uncle's son. He plays that music instrument so nicely. Oh, really? So, like, he is made first hero. Before that, also in family, there are so many heroes. And then they would introduce, अरे उसको देखो उसने ऐसा किया बेटा इसको देखो इसने ऐसा किया. So Indian parents always have this. They will make so many heroes in your life. In fact, after some time, you lose the count, right? And I remember when I was in my 8th standard and then 9th standard and then 10th standard, my God, so many heroes lined up. बेटा इसको देखो इसने डॉक्टरी किया. जिसके पास लेके जाए माँ बाप वहां पे एक हीरो तैयार. ये देखो बेटा इसने IIT किया. देखो बेटा कहाँ चला गया ये. देखो इसने ऐसा किया. लाइक वन ऑफ द टाइम्स व्हेन आई वेंट आफ्टर ज्वाइनिंग द टेम्पल, सो व्हेनेवर आई वुड गो होम लाइक वंस और ट्वाइस इन अ ईयर, सो माय मदर वुड ऑलवेज टेल मी अबाउट सम पीपल. बेटा देख तुमने भी इंजीनियरिंग किया इन्होंने भी किया. आज तुम देखो कहाँ हो आज ये देखो कहाँ है. So she always had that kind of veer rasa with me. So one of the people she would always tell me about was one bhaiya who was there near our home in the neighboring home. So his name was Nikku bhaiya. So he my mother would say, देख बेटा Nikku को देख. Nikku bhaiya तुम्हारे साथ थोड़े से एक दो साल आगे थे तुम्हारे साथ. तुमसे अच्छे कॉलेज में नहीं पढ़े तुमसे थोड़े नीचे वाले कॉलेज में पढ़े. लेकिन आज देखो अमेरिका में क्या कर रहे हैं. फिर अगली बार जाओ तो बेटा उसकी शादी हो गई. कितनी अच्छी लड़की लेकर आए गृह लक्ष्मी. एंड देन दे गॉट अ किड देन ही गॉट अ बेटर जॉब सो ही इज मेड अ हीरो. एंड देन आई रिमेंबर वन ऑफ द इयर्स शी स्टॉप टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो आई वाज वंडरिंग इफ टू डेज हैव पास्ड शी हैज नॉट टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस टू थ्री गाइस. आई आस्क्ड मम्मी वो Nikku भैया का क्या हुआ. सो शी इज टेलिंग या ही इज देयर सो व्हाट यू डू योर वर्क I do my work. Some gadbad is there. So I asked her, I pressed her. What about Nikku bhaiya? Tell me. Arey, sabka apna apna jeevan hai. Tumhe kya karna? Apna apna jeevan hai. Hey, something is gadbad. Please tell me about Nikku bhaiya. What happened to him? And then she said, you know, arey, his wife got cancer and this happened, that happened. So many things happened. I immediately understood. See, in this world, there will be so many people who for some point of time will become attractive figures because of some little attractive elements in their life. Maybe fame, maybe wealth, maybe beauty, you know. I remember two of my classmates, I had kind of, you know, some attraction to the girls in my school days. And not like, I could feel it inside my heart. It's not very great thing, this thing. But, and I never acted upon it by Krishna's grace. But then that attraction was there. And few years back when I had visited my home, I got to see them. So interestingly, they both became like so different actually, not at all attractive now physically. So I was actually just wondering that see with time, all these attractions towards people in this world, all towards places, big buildings, they get rusted, what all things happen to them. Mobile phones. In our time, mobile phone means Nokia. Today, Nokia is nowhere. Nowhere in the picture. So, you see, in this world, the empires keep changing, the emperors keep changing, the brands keep changing, the trends keep changing, and the attractive people, their positions keep changing. And what attracts us to somebody, even that principle of attraction in the material world, the principle remains, but the details keep changing. So the whole point is, our nature is to be attracted to somebody. Then why are we getting attracted to all these people? And who is the person whom we should get attracted to? What will be our real role model, our ideal, our master? And then Srimad Bhagavatam gives us the answer. And Srila Rupa Goswami gives us the answer in his definition of God. That God means one who is full in six opulences. So all these people you see, somebody is beautiful, somebody is wealthy, somebody is knowledgeable, somebody is famous, somebody is renowned. But then all these people, they have those elements not in full, little bit only. And second thing, they don't have it permanent, right? It changes. Today somebody is beautiful, tomorrow somebody else is beautiful. And third thing, they don't have it simultaneously. Right? Generally, those who are very knowledgeable, they're not very, they are famous, but generally they are not very beautiful necessarily, or they're not very strong, right? I think I'll hold this. So we find that in this world, people, they don't have all the six opulences together. But Krishna is one person who has permanently all the six opulences in full and together simultaneously. And the most amazing element is that he also loves us and is willing to be attracted to our love if we offer it to him. So that is why we have to learn this principle of that how God means, by very definition of God, is full in six opulences. And that's what this topic is all about. And we are going to see those opulences one after another presented by different devotees. And although Krishna can be glorified for all eternity to come, even his one single quality can be glorified for all time to come. And yet, we will try to stick to 15 to 20 minutes per quality. So let us begin with the quality of fame. So I'll just share with you a PPT on your screen. And just 1 minute. Yeah, I hope you are able to see on your screen the PPT. So, fame of Sri Krishna. See, in India, God is so famous that every day everybody talks about it. Like yesterday. In our festival here, so one of the couples who came, one family I was just sharing that one couple, they came, one family, and they had a small child. Okay, his name is Amog. So they were telling me that, Prabhuji, see, he does your mimicry. I said, okay, mimicry? Okay, how he does mimicry? And then immediately the little child, he said, you know, oh my God. So I have this habit of saying, oh my God. So he immediately said, oh my God. So the entire point is, in India, we always have this that we say, oh my God, or hey Bhagwan, you know, like, you know, you'll see elders and everybody saying this, you know, locally, everywhere, right from our childhood, we'll see this. So even the atheists say this, oh God, hey Bhagwan, hey Prabhu, you know, like my father would always say, you know, hey Prabhu, kahan hai tu? In my childhood. So we had one... in my father's factory, there was one guard. So, uska naam Prabhu tha. So, as a small child, I would always say innocently, Prabhu to factory par hai. And they would laugh because they were remembering God. So, this is India. Okay. And you find that Krishna is so famous, he's everywhere. In India, there is nowhere where Krishna is not there. Okay, let me share with you one... Yeah, I hope you are able to see on your screen. There is one picture of, there is a map of India. And in that you can see, like in the north, there is Kurukshetra, where Krishna performed the Bhagavad Gita. You know, Then there is Badrinath, right? There is this Janmasthan of Krishna in Mathura, right? There is all the Radha Krishna deities, and Krishna himself sported in Vrindavan, and right then like this, all so many. In Jaipur you have Govind Devji, near Jaipur you have Madan Mohanji. Then below, if you come again on the border of MP, Rajasthan, Gujarat, you have the Srinath Ji, Nath Dwara, Gopal Ji. In Gujarat, Gujarat is famous for Dwarkadhish. You come to Maharashtra, it's famous for Vithala. And you go to Karnataka, it's famous for Udupi Krishna. And then you go to Kerala, there is Guruvayurappan, and there is Guruvayurappan. Okay, this something is happening. You know, I have to disable. Where?
Prabhuji, you need to go to that security option which is showing the shield, and there is an option of, at the last, there is an option of allow annotation for other participants. You just click that. That's all.
Annotate on shared content. That
now? So that you remove. So no participant can annotate.
Yeah.
And you can choose to.
I've done it.
Yeah. Okay, and thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
So you see, Krishna is so famous. Practically everywhere Krishna is there. You know, in South India again, you have Tirupati Balaji, you have in Srirangam Ranganath Swami, and you have in Kanchipuram Varadaraj, you have Jagannath in Puri, and in Bengal there is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu everywhere. So practically anywhere you go, what to say of states, you go to different regions and states also, Krishna is everywhere. And people know so many names of God. Bhagavad Katha, still it is everywhere. Even in this prime of Kali Yuga, practically Bhagavad Katha keeps happening everywhere. Bhagavad Gita, our politicians are still talking about Bhagavad Gita. Corporates, everywhere they are talking of Bhagavad Gita. Where are people who are not talking of God? Even atheists are very busy discussing about God. That's how famous he is. You know, I mean, how much people are absorbed actually. Day and night they are talking of God. Something bad happens, hey Bhagwan, kya kar rahe ho? India means there is no pure atheist. It is not possible only. You go to shop names, Vrindavan something, some cloth store, okay? Krishna Samadhar store, Mukund Samadhar store. And half of Indians' names are connected to God, somehow or other. South India, sometimes you'll find a person's name, 5-6 words, okay, in that. And 3 words will be connected to Krishna. He's 3 times God in that sense. I mean, he's 3 times reminding us of God. So it's simply amazing, actually. People's names of their homes, you know. Like my, the home where I grew up. So my parents, they had named as, that as Bhagavati, you know, Bhagavati Villa. Which means the place where the Lord's Bhakti resides. So there is this thing in the Indian blood. And even if you go outside, there are, outside India, they'll put those crosses and so many other symbols actually. So this is how famous God is. People are doing all researches on that. Even right now, there are many IITs and other institutes where researches are going on. How spirituality affects people, affects individuals, affects families, affects cultures. How the chanting of God's names affects everyone. So that means God is literally the most famous person. Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita for 45 minutes or so, 45 minutes to 60 minutes. That's how much time Krishna and Arjuna took in their original discussion at Kurukshetra. And now still everybody is discussing about it. This is the glory of Krishna. So now let us go back to the PPT. So fame of Sri Krishna. See, here you find Devaki Nandan and Vasudev. So Krishna was born to, as an external appearance, Krishna was born to Vasudeva and Devaki. And he was immediately known as Devaki Nandana and Vasudev. So Krishna was so attractive that even before his birth, everybody was talking about it. You know? Because Kamsa was talking about it, everybody was talking about it. It was already announced from the skies as Akashvani. Later on, whatever pastimes Krishna did, Krishna got a name like Yashoda Nandana, Nandanandana. Eternally. See, when Krishna was trying to serve his father, Nanda Maharaj, even as that picker of somebody who picks up the chappals of his parents. Even in doing that, he was very attractive, you know, and he became famous as one who was lifting his father's sandals. So, and then further ahead, you see, Krishna became famous as Vrindavan and Natvara. See, in this world, people want to become famous on India's Got Talent. And what is it? In our time, there was one show called Boogie Woogie. I don't know if it comes any longer. And there is this one more, na? Dance India Dance. Some show is there. So on all these shows, how do people dance? They want to dance on some very nice platform. Actually, if you go and see those platforms, na, they're very, very expertly made. Because they're made in a very professional way. Like you don't slip on that. If your sweat drops, then it is immediately absorbed. Okay. And the light doesn't reflect on that. Light will reflect from around, but not on that. There are many features in that. Another feature is it doesn't hurt your knee. Because see, I used to play badminton at national level in my teenage days. So these are exactly the same elements which are put up in professional, international, national level badminton courts, tennis courts, especially badminton courts. Because like when you're running so much na, and your pressure goes so much on your knees. So the whole idea is that the shoes and the that the floor, the court, that is designed with such a material that has some level of flexibility, at a very molecular level. And even if you jump with full force, it actually aids your knees and your ankles. And another thing is, it is not at all slippery. There is a coefficient of friction, right? You all have studied about it. So they design it in such a way that you can immediately change your moves, change your directions, change your speed. Immediately you can put brake and still not get hurt or get toppled over. That is how they design all these floors. Then they also see the reflection of light. Just like the cricket batsman, na, when he plays the screen, I don't know whether they still do it, but in our time, they used to do this screen thing, move it, do this, do that, right? So see, in this world, to dance or to do anything, we need so many. These are like just some features, like the racket which we use in badminton, that badminton racket and the shuttlecock. They are all very, very, very particularly designed. Point XY gram also is actually, you know, weighed. And the lesser the weight they have, like there is this Carbon X racket which comes. It is the least weight in that the series comes. And I used to always save money to buy those rackets. And then the Yonex cock, the shuttlecock. So in this world, we have so many conditions under which only then for a few minutes, little bit, some so-called performance we can give. Even for cooking, we need so many. This masala should be there. Some people are like very particular. Aisa hona chahiye, waisa hona chahiye, tabhi main karunga. Kuch jo gaane wale hote hain, those people who sing, this instrument should be there in this condition. Mic should be there like this. It should not happen like this, like that. Then only I will sing. There should be AC. Like now I'm sweating because it rained heavily last 3-4 days. So there's a lot of humidity. You know, but some people like, I'll only speak or I'll only do this if there is a AC around or there is something, right? But Krishna was such an amazing dancer that he was dancing on the hooves of Kaliya. Just imagine dance. Arey, we look at a snake only and we are like, oh my God, you know, and Krishna was dancing on the hooves of Kaliya, who specifically wanted to kill him and was filled with poison. Which could actually kill an entire city or probably an entire state, the kind of poison it is described. And he had more than 1,000 hoods, more than 1,000 major hoods. That's what is described in the Bhagavatam. And all those hoods were attacking on Krishna. And Krishna was just a little boy. And he had to also give the musical effects. He was playing on his flute. Okay, and he was dancing. And on one hood, he would dance. Like Radhishyam Prabhu says this, tak dhinna tak dhinna tak dhinna tak. So if you've seen the classical music in our college, NIT Suratkal, there was this pick meke. So I used to see the classical dances in my first year. And then this, so like the Krishna is dancing on Kaliya's hood. So on these kind of bits, tak dhinna tak dhinna. So he's dancing, playing flute also. And then suddenly the Kaliya starts, you know, throwing so many other hoods on that. So Krishna has to jump, tak tuck-a-ding, so like this is dancing on all the different hoods, right? And it's like Kali is wondering. So just like Krishna had the most amazing way to purify Indra, if you have heard of the Govardhan Leela pastime. I mean, where is such a master who will humble a servant who is a devotee who has become proud, you know? Or a son, like my father used to humble me sometime when I used to do mistakes. That was not in a madhure way, okay, in a not so loving way. I used to become football and he used to become Pele. He used to like football. So he used to beat me like solidly. And used to thrash me with words also. But Krishna is such a master, in a very madhure way, in a very loving way, in a very attractive way, in a very sweet way, he's dancing on Kaliya to lower his pride. And he did that Govardhan Leela to shatter the pride of Indra and to again make them his humble, attractive devotees actually. So, and as Krishna was dancing on the hoods of Kaliya, he was playing flute also. So Kaliya's surface is, first of all, he's in the water. So all that water is there on his surface. Second, it's not a flat surface. Third, it is snake. It is by nature slippery. Fourth, there's a lot of poison around. And fifth, the whole stage is changing. The whole stage only is moving around. So by the time you jump, where you land, you don't know. Okay. And the Vrindavan Vasis were watching actually from the banks of the river Yamuna. And it was for their pleasure that Krishna was actually dancing in that way. And does Krishna want to become the number one in India's Got Talent? No. The song which the Acharyas have written, like the Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written this song, you know, Vrindavana Natavara, where he calls Krishna as Vrindavana Natavara. Yashomati Nandana Braja Baranagara. In that song, he says Krishna is Vrindavana Natavara. Krishna wants to become the most favorite dancer of Vrindavan. Vrindavan is a small village. Even if you say to somebody today that, okay, you will become famous in your own class as a dancer. No, at least school mein I'll come first. And the district, mein, you know. So that is Krishna actually. You know, he's the best dancer, he's the best everything. See, Partha Sarthi. Who can become such a humble servant of his friend? Any of us can become driver of our friends. Tomorrow our friend becomes a big CEO. If our friend says, Dinna Prabhu, every day you serve prasadam to me, it'll be a big test actually. Krishna became famous as Partha Sarthi. And in the way he drove the chariot, that was also fantastic. You'll get to hear it in future. And then Krishna became famous as Makhan Chor. So you would have heard definitely about this. Like when Krishna would steal butter, so the gopis would go and complain to Mother Yashoda. They would say that Maya Yashoda Kana Ne Makhan Churaya. Like they would sing and tell actually. Can you believe it? Somewhere a person can be so attractive that even when he's stealing, people are complaining with music actually. Like imagine somebody is in somebody's house, there is some theft and maybe 5 lakh rupees got stolen. You know, so do they go to the police and they say, you know, Bhaiya inspector, hamare ghar mein 5 lakh ki chori ho gayi. Nobody says like that. But Krishna is Makhan Chor. He does little chori of little Makhan. And the whole world is talking till now about it. You know, our one devotee, Naman Arora Prabhu, the first year devotee, like he must be there right now. So he made a painting actually to give to Krishna on Janmashtami day. And he made of this picture only. It's natural actually. Krishna is so famous like that. So, yeah. And then Krishna as Ranachod. So Krishna jumped from the 88 miles actually to run away from Jarasandha, who was chasing him with an entire army. And why did Krishna run from him? Actually, Krishna was going to defeat him the 18th time. But what happened that he got a love letter from Rukmini. Yes, the original love letter from Rukmini. And in that love letter, Rukmini had glorified Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And she had never seen Krishna till that time. She only wrote that, I heard from Narad Muni about you. And I want to become your servant. I want to assist you. I want to serve you. I want to be there at your side. You know, I want to chant your names. So when Krishna got that letter, he had also not seen Rukmini. Of course, he has seen Rukmini in that sense, but Krishna was attracted to the love of Rukmini, to the humility of Rukmini, and especially to the service attitude of Rukmini. And immediately he left, which means he can be so renounced. Srimad Bhagavatam 3rd canto says that Krishna had planned, when he appeared as the son of Devaki and Vasudev, he had planned to immediately kill Kamsa. He didn't plan to go to Vrindavan immediately. But when Devaki and Vasudev intensely offered this prayer that Krishna, oh dear son, we want to actually serve you by hiding you somewhere, because otherwise Kamsa will kill you. And Krishna was smiling, come on, how can he kill me? You know, nobody can do anything to me. But they said, no, you are the Supreme Lord. That is very crystal clear. So either you make Kamsa forget about you totally, or you have to hide somewhere. Allow us to hide you somewhere, otherwise he'll kill you. You're just a small child. Later on, maybe you can kill him. And Krishna was so renounced that he immediately agreed to their proposal and he changed his plans. Okay, then change of plans. You take me to Vrindavan. You know, let Kamsa live for some time. You want to serve me? Fine. This is how amazing Krishna is. And he became famous as Ranchod in this pastime of running away from Rukmini, because he left the battlefield. Ran ko chhod ke jo bhage, wo Ranchod. Aaj bhi Gujarat mein unka temple hai. Similarly, Krishna became famous as Muralidhar. When he would play the flute on its fifth note, every living entity would get attracted. Stones would melt, flowers would start blooming, and the bloom flowers would start crying. The trees, you know, they're from them, the very nice type of sap would start coming, the tears of ecstasy, and the honeybees, so much honey would ooze out of them. The clouds, they would gather together and they would sing along with Krishna by making those sounds. Like, you know, they would sync with Krishna. The oceans and rivers, their waves, they would sync with Krishna when Krishna would play with his murli. His the sound of his flute would attract every living entity's heart and totally satisfy them. In fact, it is said that the Hare Krishna Mahamantra which we chant, when we get more purified by chanting, we'll never be able to leave this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Why? Because there is the sound of the flute of Krishna coming from the Golok Vrindavan. And it takes the form of Hare Krishna Mahamantra in this world. In fact, we know of some cases where some devotees, due to some accident or some other disease, they lost their memory. Recently, one week back, one old lady devotee in Maharashtra, Jalna, she's the mother of one brahmachari. So she lost her memory due to paralysis in the body. And when she came back, like from that paralytic attack, so she became physically all right, but she's not remembering anything. Her name, the place where she lives, family members, nothing. Anything you ask her, she says, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. There have been many cases like this in the history, that so many devotees we've seen with our naked eyes, that they remember this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And Indradhanu Maharaj's mother also, same case. How? Because this sound is a transcendental sound vibration. So when Krishna plays flute also, he becomes famous as Muralidhar. Rathanga Pani, person who became famous to break his vow. We don't become famous to break our vow because we keep breaking it every day. We become famous if we follow the vow. Like Radheshyampu is known as the man who will keep his word. Man of his word. He'll come at sharp at time. He'll do what he says. And he'll say what he does. So there are very few people of such impeccable character actually. But Krishna is such a person that for love, out of love for his devotees, he became Rathanga Pandi. I'll also lift the weapon now. And he became famous. Similarly, he became famous as Bakari. Bakari means one who killed Baka, the demon called Baka. Similarly, Kamsari, one who killed Kamsa. And the way Krishna kills also is very interesting, huh? Every person. Similarly, he becomes famous as Radhanath, the Lord of Radha, or Madhava, one who gives pleasure to Radha. Similarly, he becomes famous as Gopijana Vallabha, one who is the greatest well-wisher and greatest lover and caretaker of all the gopis, Gopijana, all the Brajavasis. Similarly, Kheer Chor Gopinath, person who stole kheer. This is an amazing story, so sometime we can hear it. Kheer Chor Gopinath. So he was Gopinath actually before that, but he stole for his devotee Madhavendra Puri, the kheer which Madhavendra wanted to taste. And he became famous Kheer Chor Gopinath. Similarly, in Ranganath, similarly in Srirangam in South India, he is known as Ranganath Swami, where he's simply, you know, sleeping. So, does anyone go to see a sleeping person? Never, actually. But Krishna is like that. Some water touches his feet, oh, Charanamrit, that becomes Ganges. And when he's sleeping, millions of people are coming to see him sleeping, you know. So, similarly, Udupi is there in South India, where so many people again come. It's near Suratkal. And similarly, Tirupati Balaji. Tirupati Balaji is anyway so famous. And when Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita, entire world is talking. And by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, by Srila Prabhupada's mercy, now Krishna's names are spread everywhere. The Janmashtami we celebrated here, every country Janmashtami was celebrated. Do you know something? In like here we offered 221 items. Okay, we're just ending in 2 minutes. It's like I've already taken more time, I guess. So, yes. So, in every country of the world, Janmashtami was celebrated. Do you know that? And here we offered 221 items in Varanasi on this festival. Actually, we were also amazed how our devotees could do that. But we somehow could do that. 221 items. And so many other things we offered to Krishna. Now, if you see internet, YouTube is flooded with Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna everywhere. Every day, so much of live, so much of webinars. This, that. Zoom must be like getting crazy with ISKCON devotees, you know, using all the free accounts. And by Prabhupada's amazing hard work and his diligence to serve Krishna, his devotion, his pure service attitude, unlimited desire to serve Krishna, he made Krishna famous everywhere in the entire world. There are, in every country of the world, there are Radha Krishna temples. There are 2-3 places in the world where Indian software engineers are not yet there, but there is Radha Krishna temple. In London, in the main heart of the London, where traffic is not stopped even for US president, even for UK president, UK prime minister, even for the Queen of England, traffic is not stopped for more than 2 minutes. And when ISKCON Rath Yatra is done, for 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, traffic is stopped even on Fifth Avenue. Shri Jagannath Ji ki jai. This is how famous Krishna is. This is how famous Prabhupada made Krishna. This is how famous Prabhupada made the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And see, Krishna reciprocates. Now Krishna has made Prabhupada famous everywhere. You know, everyone is chanting Jai Prabhupada. And one last thing I'll share with you. One time I went to Vrindavan with devotees that took me. And there, in our Krishna Balaram temple in Vrindavan. So in Vrindavan, there are so many temples. But if you're looking for intense devotion and ecstatic devotion, that's there in Krishna Balaram, ISKCON temple. So when you go there, so there is a Mahaprasad counter. So one time one devotee told some of us that there were some cookies, okay? Every day they give out those cookies and some cakes. So those are directly offered to Krishna Balaram. So he was telling the value of those cookies. He said, the flour for these cookies, okay, that was grown in one country in Europe, like Germany. And he said, then that is taken by some devotees, you know, in some another country. And from another country, some other ingredients like this carob. So in those countries, the scarab is not there. So they get from another country. In America or Canada somewhere. And then, so like 3-4 countries, the ingredients are there. And in one totally different country, it is made. The cookies are made. And sometimes the devotee comes and he directly comes to the New Delhi airport and he brings the cookies. And next day it is offered in Vrindavan by two different pujaris of again different countries, Africa or somewhere. And then that is purchased by devotees or, you know what, we cannot purchase prasad, but like taken by some devotees and they bring it to Bombay, Pune or Delhi or different places, you know, and then they give and then you take it. Even the emperor of, even the US president does not get this type of prasad. In ISKCON, if you're simply a brahmachari or a devotee in the temple, you know, and you keep getting prasad from all different kinds of places, all different countries and different types of places. Now, we don't have Facebook account. We don't have Twitter and Instagram. But we know devotees everywhere in the entire world. We can go anywhere. Krishna is famous everywhere. And you go and say, Hare Krishna, code word accepted. Krishna is famous, you are famous. Hari Bol. So this is how actually we are so fortunate. So thanks to Srila Prabhupada. Now we know about Krishna. East or West, Krishna is the best. So we'll end with this verse. Shrutva gunan bhuvana sundara shrinvatam te nirvishakarna vivarai haratonga tapam rupam drisham drishimatam akhilartha labham twayachyuta vishati chittam apatripam me. Shri Rukmini said, oh beauty of the worlds, having heard of your good qualities, which enters the ears of those who hear and remove their bodily distress, and having also heard of your beauty, which fulfills all the visual desires of those who see, I have fixed my shameless mind upon you, O Krishna. So let our mind and senses and talents and intelligence and ego and desires and everything become fixed on Krishna, who is the most famous. Hare Krishna. So thank you very much for your kind attention. So Pankaj Gopru now will invite Mukundanan Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much Achyut Mahaprabhu for a very wonderful and enlightening session on the opulence of Krishna called fame. So we have our next guest speaker who will be elaborating on the next quality. So I'll just share my screen. So we have amongst us Dr. P. Hare Krishna, Dr. Hare Krishna Anand Prabhu. So Dr. Hare Krishna Anand Prabhu is an ex-associate dean, research and consultancy. He is the head of the geotechnical division from NIT Warangal. He is the vice president of Teachers Association, secretary of the Indian Geotechnical Society. He has an experience of teaching, 20 years of experience of teaching and 14 years of research experience. He has published 16 international journals, attended 58 conferences and published one international book. On the occasion of Engineers Day 2015, Institution of Engineers London selected his technical paper as the best paper from India. He's also visited the University of Texas at Arlington, USA on research purpose on behalf of the government of India. He has completed his MHRD sponsor project on high quality, low cost ferrous cement housing. He's also university fifth ranker in his BTEC and institute second topper during his master's. He was also awarded the best paper for two consecutive years by the Indian Geotechnical Society in New Delhi. He's also an advisor to the Civil Engineering Association and the Center for Education. Just recently, he was also awarded the Best Citizens of India Award 2019. Here we have the certificate which was conferred upon Hare Krishna Anand Prabhu with this most distinguished award. So he's also, I have personally interacted with Prabhuji many a times, and he's a very, very amazing personality, very humble at heart, very down to earth. And every time I met Prabhuji, it has always been a new learning experience, you know, for me especially, you know, interactions with him. So let us extend a very hearty, warm welcome and gratitude to Hare Krishna Anand Prabhu for coming and, you know, taking out his very valuable time to give to the students and participants of Utkarsha 2020. Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Hope I'm audible, Ashutosh Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhuji, you're audible.
Thank you very much. Thank you. First of all, I extend my greatest gratitude for all the devotees, starting from my spiritual mentor, spiritual guide, His Grace Radhesham Prabhu, under whose guidance I started my spiritual life, for giving this opportunity to Antardeep Prabhu, Pankaj Mohan Prabhu, and all others. And of course, as all of you know, we had wonderful starting batsman, Achyut Mohan Prabhu, very well played. Now I will be having another great player who will be coming next. Mukundananda Prabhu is another, like a big batsman. In between, there is a small batsman, please remember. I'll try to complete this session within 15-20 minutes so that we can accommodate Mukundananda Prabhu for a good time. ओके अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुर उन्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपादांतिकं मा ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेशा गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचना गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 रामो राम रामो हरे हरे Hare Krishna. So after hearing such a wonderful talk by Achyut Mohan Prabhu regarding greatest fame quality of Krishna, let us warm up for strength aspect of Krishna now. If you know, he has, as Prabhuji has mentioned, we have six opulences for Krishna. And the next aspect what we are taking is a strength aspect. Hope the slide is there. PPT is coming. Prabhuji? Ashutosh Prabhu, is it okay?
Yes, yeah. Prabhuji.
So as we see in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that Eto Chamsakala Pumsa Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam Indrari Vyakulam Lokam Mrudayanti Yuge Yuge. It is being said that the person who is Krishna, he is Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. He is, although we have so many incarnations, but he is right now, he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. So he comes just to make so many wonderful things, and therefore we have this great personality, Supreme Personality of Godhead, being called as Bhagavan. Bhagavan, as per the greatest authority, that is Parasari Muni, who is the father of Vyasadeva, is the person who has these six wonderful qualities, that is all riches, all strength, which you are going to see now, and of course all fame, all beauty, knowledge and all renunciation. The person is called Bhagavan. Now, as we said now, the person with beauty, the person with strength, person with fame, of course, with knowledge and wealth, and lastly, renunciation. That person which exhibits these six opulences is Bhagavan. As we have clearly seen now, he has exhibited wonderful fame. Now we'll see what is the strength aspects. As we know from the childhood itself, Krishna did so many wonderful pastimes, starting with the Putana. All of us heard this story so many number of times. But when I'm sometimes when I'm hearing His Grace Radhishyam Prabhu or His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj, we'll be getting some important points. You know, when a child is months old baby, he or she doesn't have even teeth. You know, when they have only gums, and the holding power of gums is not that good. You know, whenever you want to hold something tightly, you should have such a grip mechanism. Any engineering student who knows mechanics, engineering mechanics, all these things, they know the grip has to be there to hold something. But when Putana came for the purpose of killing Krishna in the form of giving her breast milk, Krishna started taking breast milk. Along with the breast milk, he started sucking her life air also. So when she realized that it is going to happen, that greatest danger is going to happen, she started screaming. She started making Krishna to leave her body. But Krishna held her breast such a way that she could not get rid of her, get rid of him. So he caught her breast like anything. So he has such a great power and strength. Although she is such a big Rakshasi, she could not dare, she could not make Krishna leave her body. And similarly, Sakatasura, he came in the form of air and filling that cart. When Krishna is just small babies, when they are hungry, when they wake up after sleep, we all of know this pastime also. He started just moving his hands and legs like this and just hit the cart. And Sakatasura, who was there trying and waiting for the chance to crush Krishna, has gone into the air. Millions of kilometers on the top of it. Then we have similarly Trunavarta, he was coming as such a wind, swirling wind, and Krishna just hold his throat, and he crushed him such a way that he suffocated and was no more. She came down from air, from top of the sky, just crushed onto the earth. And of course, as we have seen, wonderful Damodar Leela pastime, Nalakuvera Manigreeve. These two great personalities were in the form of trees, and Krishna just made a small attempt with that binding mortar. You know, when he is coming like that, there was a hurdles, and just he pulled, entire big tamal trees fell down, and there come Nalakuver and Manigreeve. So like this, he made so many wonderful pastimes. Similarly, Vatsasura and Bakasura, he killed so easily these two great Rakshasas also. And coming to the case of Agasura, Agasura is such a big snake running over kilometers. Anybody who sees this, all the gopas, all the friends of Krishna, assumed that it's a big cave, a tunnel in a big mountain. And just they walked and ran into the cave. And some of them were horrified by seeing the smell and the conditions there. Some of their friends said, come on, yaar, Krishna is there. Nobody can do anything for us. So that is the power and strength of Krishna, everybody know. So like that, he also killed Agasura. And what to speak of course, wonderfully explained by Achyut Mohan Prabhu. He killed Kaliya so easily. As he was telling, dancing on a slippery floor is really, really, really great task. Many of us, I don't know, we made some small attempts during our student life. You know, we also make some dances, whether you say A dance, B dance, rock dance, swing dance, something like that. Break dance, sometimes we break our body parts also. But Krishna, of course, we go for dancing on a proper surface where there is no slippery. But Krishna did this pastime of dancing on the hoods of Kaliya, as was explained by Prabhuji now, on such a mysterious conditions where it is totally slippery and it is not even. It is totally at different levels. He has to jump this way, that way. But he had been doing that one so comfortably without having any trace of discomfort. While playing flute, he was dancing like anything. That is the strength of Krishna. And similarly, when we think of Aristasura and Keshi, who are very, very big demons, he also killed them very easily. That is the power. And what to speak of Yomasura? And of course, even Brahma, he could not have that realization and knowledge who is Bhagavan, who is Krishna. Even Brahma got bewildered over the activities and pastimes, leelas of Krishna. When he take off all the friends and cows and calves from Vrindavan, who are very dear to Krishna, Krishna showed his achinta sakti in making or being in the forms of all his friends. He took as the form of all the friends, all cows, all calves. So that is the power of Krishna. And coming to the very important part of Govardhan Leela, this is one of the greatest pastime where everyone has to admire the strength of Krishna. Because of Indra's pride, he made such a condition in Vrindavan wherein no shelter for any of the residents of Raja. So therefore, Krishna took up this task of saving them. So how to save? He has to have a big umbrella. All of us have seen umbrella. Nowadays, rainy season is going on. Whenever you use an umbrella, at the most one person or maximum two, three. But when he want to accommodate all hundreds, thousands of residents of Vrindavan, he needs such a big umbrella. So he took the umbrella of Govardhan. And when we think of this Govardhan, he has not had any other ways other than his hand. So he started lifting Govardhan in the hand, in his hand, on his hand only. Initially, he took his palm to support as a base of this Govardhan. But when his mother, Shodamai, came, asked him, hey, Kanna, are you feeling any pain? Or is your hand not paining? He says, Mama, it is so light like a feather. You see, I will be able to lift it with my small finger. And as many of us have used this finger, for some basic purpose, to represent that we have to attend some natural calls. Never we have used this finger for any major and tangible purpose. If at all you want to represent any good thing, either we go for this thumb or this like this, but this finger, you know, it is very, very small and not indicating of good things. But even Krishna had such a strength in this small finger. He could lift it not for 1 or 2 minutes, 1 or 2 seconds, 1 or 2 hours. He has made this one being like that for 7 days and 7 nights. And as all of us know, sometimes we also do some weightlifting. May not be we, but there are some professional weightlifters. Just yesterday, there was an incident in Moscow, Russia. There is one person, Alexander Sedek. He want to have this Guinness Book of Records. He thought of lifting 400 kgs of weight. It was there in the news today. When he tried to do this, he could not make it even lifted properly. And he has lost his legs. There were so many problems. You know, he's totally lost one of his leg. So like this, these weightlifters will be going for this activity only for a few minutes. But Krishna lifted this for hours, days, 7 nights continuously. That is the power. Of course, Indra came begging forgiveness and Krishna forgave them. Now, as many of us have visited Govardhan, I want to present a small interesting thing. And as you can see, this Govardhan will be generally in the shape of a rectangle like this, with a big length and small width. And when I, as I know, basically engineers, we want some proofs, some calculations, some equations. When I thought of having what could be the weight of this approximately, of course, I am a civil engineering guy. Student of civil engineering, faculty of civil engineering, when I thought of what could be the approximate weight of this hill, Govardhan Hill, I was surprised. Could anyone have an idea? Is there anyone with an engineering background who can expect and approximately can think of what could be the weight of this Govardhan Hill? Any guess? Okay. So, okay, we'll go for some small calculations. All of us know mathematics. We know engineering mechanics and strength of materials, all these things. If we just see the approximate weight of Govardhan by taking the approximate shape, by taking the circumference, that is a small projection of, we call 12 kilometers. If we divide the circumference into length and breadth, approximately, when we are gone for, because I'm from civil engineering background, I know the density or unit weight of this rock in general will be from 2 to 3.5 ton per meter cube. I took an average of 2.5 and I've gone for small calculations wherein I could find that it is around 10 crore tons. The weight of the hill is 10 crore tons. In kilograms, if we convert it, it is 10,000 crore kilograms. Mind you guys, it is such a huge weight. And he is lifting this one with a small effort, with the smallest part of the body, that's the smallest weak finger. That is the strength of Krishna. And mind you, we also made civil engineers in India especially, we also made such type of efforts. Of course, this is a L&T building. Anyone who is from Chennai or who knows Chennai nicely, in Chennai we have this building in Manakpakkam area in Chennai. And the speciality of this L&T office building in Chennai is, it doesn't have, as you can see here, of course, maybe some civil engineering background or anyone who has studied mechanics, engineering mechanics can understand this. Many times we will be having building in this manner with a proper floor, and the floor will be resting on some pillars which will be going to the foundation. This is a general trend of the buildings. But this L&T building was so wonderfully designed, such a way that this is the floor and this will be the pillar or foundation. As you can see here, this is the small foundation. But when I say small, when compared to the building, it is small. But the dimension of this pillar is around 2 meters by 2 meters. Such a big, huge pillar is there. And this pillar is resting on foundation. What I wish to inform you here is, whenever we think of transferring of loads, we will be going for uniform distributed load, either on pillars or on foundations. But here, when you think of Krishna, as you can see here, it is a point load. Any civil engineering background student can easily understand what is point loads, what is uniformly distributed loads. Now we have to understand here, Krishna took up the greatest task of, never will be having such a circumstance where the load will be transferred as point load in the nature. that Krishna did this pastime, wherein he transferred this entire load of 10 crore tons of load through a small little finger. That's a point load. And mind you, friends, there is no center of gravity issue for Krishna. But whenever we think of doing some activity, lifting anything, we have to worry about a center of gravity of this. All of us have studied in first year engineering mechanics. In engineering mechanics, the most important thing is you have to match the center of gravity of the body and center of gravity of the supporting system. But for Krishna, it is not like that. He can lift anywhere for any amount of time, for any type of load. So after understanding this, as he mentioned in Bhagavad Gita also, he says in 7th chapter, 8th sloka, Rasoham apu kaunteya prabhasmi sisishuryayo pranava sarva vedeshu shabdhake paurusham runusu. He says, I am the sound in ether and I am the ability in man. When I say man, it is humans. As you can see, this person, he has such a wonderful six-pack body, such a muscles. And he says that is Krishna. Whatever power he has, whatever ability he has in making this equipment moving, that is Krishna here. And similarly, in 7.10, he again says, Bijammam sarva bhutanam vidhi parda sanatanam buddhir buddhi mata masmi tejoste jahvinamaham. So he says that he is the original seed of all existences. And of course, his intelligence of intelligence. And importantly, to the present context, is the prowess of all powerful men. Powerful men, when you think of, you will be finding so many people just like Muhammad Ali, who thought that he is the greatest. When anybody interviewed him during his young age, he used to say, I am the greatest. I am the greatest. But when he got this Parkinson's disease, wherein he could not lift his even a teacup to have a sip of tea or coffee, when people interviewed him, yes, he said, I am the greatest. I am the greatest fool. So here Krishna is telling in this shloka that he is the strength of this great people. And lastly, he says in 11th shloka, Balam balavatam chaham kamaraga vinirjitam dharma vidyutho bhuteshu kamosmi bharatarshaba. He is again saying that whatever strength that is required to produce our children, that sex energy also is Krishna. So he is such a type of energy wandering all over the universe. He can make anything possible. Anything is okay for Krishna. He is all energies, whether it is the strongest, whether he is having such a capability to do anything related to strength aspect of it. This is what I thought of informing you all. Just I thought of making more room for Mukundanandan Prabhu. So I really thank one and all for giving me this opportunity, for giving a great opportunity to share whatever I know. And hopefully everybody was okay with this. Thank you very much. I thank one and all. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So Hare we would like to thank His Grace Hare Krishna Anand Prabhu for very beautifully describing this opulence of strength of Krishna. So now next we have His Grace Mukundanandan Prabhu. So I'll just give a very brief introduction about Mukundanandan Prabhu. So we have His Grace Mukundanandan Prabhu, who is he's currently a dean, the Dean Faculty Development at Dharma Institute of Technology, VIT Pune. He did his PhD from a prestigious National Chemical Laboratory, a CSIR lab of Government of India, on the modeling of multi-phase catalytic reactors. His areas of specialization include data modeling and process optimization. He has an academic experience of 16 years and industrial experience of 2 years. He has also published many papers in international conferences. He has also received many awards and achievements like the Best Teacher Award in the Chemical Department for the year 2013 and 2015. He has years of experience in the field of research and development, academics and industry, which we mentioned before. He is also very well known for his outreach style and has been awarded the Institute's Outstanding Faculty Award for 5 consecutive years. And besides that, he has also conducted many spiritual discourses in guiding students in IITs, NITs, and many of the local Pune institutes. He's also conducted many sessions abroad at Singapore, Germany, Slovenia, and Belgium. And currently he guides, and there are many youths and families who take inspiration from Mukundanand Prabhu on his wonderful Krishna conscious lifestyle. And he even guides and counsels many youth on this aspect of Krishna. So let us heartily welcome and express our gratitude to His Grace Mukundanand Prabhu for coming and coming on this forum and enlightening the youth of Utkarsha 2020. Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you very much for coming.
Hare Krishna. मम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः जय श्रीकृष्णचैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैतगदाधर श्रीवासादिगौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू हियर स्पेशली स्पेशल ग्रैटिट्यूड टू राधेश्याम प्रभु हू इज माई शिक्षा गुरु एंड ऑल्सो all the voice management that goes behind getting 300 devotees together over Zoom. So although we are missing the physical association, at the same time, Vani is always given more importance in spiritual life. And now we are already through the, you know, the two sessions, one by Achyut Mohan Prabhu, another by, you know, Hare Krishnanand Prabhu. He was giving cricket analogy, so I was just thinking, it is like, now the remaining match is like 3 runs, 60 balls and 8 wickets in hand. You know, I mean, the match becomes quite boring by then. Because already, you know, we had very two powerful speaker. Achyut Mohan Prabhu very vividly covered everything. And Hare Krishnanand Prabhu was, I mean, just awesome. To find the weight of Govardhan means, I mean, you know, you need to be really antaranga devotee of the Lord. 10,000 crores. So today we are discussing the 6 opulences. And the opulence that I'm going to describe here, we discuss here, is the beauty of the Lord. Now, one of the very interesting things about the opulences of the Lord, the 6th one, Aishwaryasya, Samagrasya, Viryasya, Yashasya, Shriyaha, Jnana, Vairagya, Yoschaiva. The 6 opulences, they are fully owned by the Lord. And they are simultaneously eternally possessed by the Lord. Generally, whenever we see an opulent personality in the material world, say, you know, Bill Gates is very rich, or there is a Einstein, he was very knowledgeable, or there is some another personality who may be very renounced. Generally, they will represent one of the opulents, but not the other opulent simultaneously. Just like there is a very nice story of Einstein, who was very famous as, you know, the most renowned scholar, the scientist. And one actress that time, she became very inspired by Einstein and she approached Einstein and she said that, why don't we marry and unite so that the child who will be as scholarly as you and will be as beautiful as me. And Einstein just laughed at the proposal and he said, what if he becomes as scholarly as you and as beautiful as me? So what it means is the material opulence is always limited. Somebody is very opulent, but he may not be very beautiful. Somebody may be very beautiful, but he may not be very knowledgeable. Somebody may be knowledgeable, but he may not be very rich. Somebody may be very rich, but again, he may not be very strong. And this constantly goes on. But only in the Supreme Lord, all the opulences reside simultaneously. The another beauty of the Lord's opulence is, the Lord possesses opulence infinitely. You know, whenever a living entity possesses opulence, how much opulence a living entity can possess? Say somebody wants to become rich. How much rich we can become? You know, somebody like Jeff Bezos, the founder of Amazon, he has some $150 billion. But the entire world GDP is around, you know, somewhere between $40 trillion. So surely one cannot become richer than the world GDP. So when the Lord possesses opulence, he possesses the opulence infinitely. Whereas the living entity, when living entity is possessing opulence, the opulence of a living entity is only fractional. The second is, when the Lord possesses opulence, the Lord's opulence is everlasting. You know, we never see that there is old Krishna who is, lost his strength. Or, we never see, the Lord who is not beautiful. Or Lord who lost his knowledge. That we'll never see. But in the material world, what we see is, somebody may be possessing opulence for one particular time period. We know very famous brothers there who started with billions of dollars. Ambani brothers. And one of them is practically a beggar on the street now. Why? Because the opulence one possesses doesn't last for a long. So this is the second thing, that the opulence is, the flickering beauty, the flickering opulence in the material world. And the third is, so we have seen these three, that the Lord possesses the opulence simultaneously, infinitely, and eternally. So the Lord's opulence is simultaneously all six, infinitely all six, and eternally all six. And therefore, the Lord's opulence are very, very special. And when we talk about the one of the opulence that we are going to discuss here is the beauty of the Lord. Again, the beauty of the Lord is also when we have the experience of the material beauty. Material beauty is very fleeting beauty. Why fleeting? Because material beauty, you will see that, the Miss Universe or Miss India or even Mr. India for that matter, there will be always a new Miss Universe or Miss India every year. Oh, you will say, what happened to the Miss India last year? No, she has become old now. We need a new beauty. So the material beauty is very fleeting. Somebody may be beautiful now. Radhesham Prabhu gives this very famous example. He says that why the actors and actresses, you will see them on screen, when they are young, but when they are old, they will hide themselves from the screen because they do not want to reveal, how old they have become. So material beauty is very fleeting. Material beauty is very illusory as well. We know that beauty is skin deep. We all have studied that story of liquid beauty, the saintly girl trying to, trying to preach to the boy who was after her and saying that the beauty is very fleeting. The beauty is illusory beauty. And ultimately the beauty, the material beauty is very dissatisfying. But that is not the case with the Lord's beauty. When the Lord is beautiful, the Lord's beauty is everlasting beauty. Everlasting beauty means the Lord is as beautiful as a child when he was a child, and he was as beautiful when he was fighting the war of Mahabharat when he was 125 years old. So when Lord is in the war of Mahabharat, that time he has sons, grandsons, great-grandsons, and he has become like a grandfather and great-grandfather. But still, the beauty of the Lord is he's always Nava Yavvanam Cha. Always ever youthful, fresh personality who has just touched 16 years old. That is the everlasting beauty of the Lord. Another is the Lord's beauty is very real. Why the Lord's beauty is real? Because the personalities who have rejected the material world and the material things, they are mad after the Lord. All across India, we see the saints. We have Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Nimbarka Swami, Vishnu Swami. You have Tukaram Maharaj, Jnaneshwar Maharaj, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Of course, he is the Lord himself. These personalities, Shukadeva Goswami, whenever any renunciation is to be compared, it is always compared with Shukadeva Goswami. In Marathi, we have this saying. It says that Shuka Sarikhe Purna Vairagya Jache. That renunciation is compared with Shukadeva Goswami. But Shukadeva Goswami is so mad after Krishna's beauty. They have rejected the material beauty. There is a very beautiful verse in Bhagavatam which says, Atma Ramascha Munayo Niragrantha Api Urukrame Kuruvanti Haituki Bhaktim Ityam Bhuta Guno Harihi. Atma Ramascha Munayo. The personalities who are fully satisfied within themselves, Nirgrantha Api Urukrame, but still they take great pleasure in describing the pastimes of the Lord. Kurvanti Ahaitukim Bhaktim, and they perform Ahaituki Bhakti towards the Lord. Kurvanti Ityam Bhuta Guno Harihi. These are the very transcendental qualities of the Lord. So the Lord's beauty is everlasting, real, and fully satisfying. as we are discussing about Ramanujacharya, there is a very beautiful story. One day it is said, Ramanujacharya's one, he was taking the procession of Ranganathji, the Utsav Murthis of the Ranganath, and they were in the procession. And, you know, whenever the procession of the Lord goes on, it is like a big procession. You know, there is a lot of Vadyas there. And then apart from the Vadya, thousands of people are following. The elephants are there. Decorations are there. I mean, it's very difficult not to get attracted by, you know, such kind of a procession. And when Ramanujacharya was, moving with this procession, suddenly he was very surprised by one sight. He saw a young man looking in the eyes of his beloved, the fiancée, and very deeply he was looking, completely neglecting the beauty of the Lord and the procession of the Lord. His name was Dhanurdas, and his wife. And Ramanujacharya, he was very surprised. He said, how can there be somebody who can completely neglect the beauty of the Lord? And then he said that you get this person. And the disciples of Ramanujacharya, they went on and they called this Dhanurdas. And the Ramanujacharya asked, my dear Dhanurdas, here when the Supreme Lord is walking here, in the procession, moving around, why do you see, what is distracting you so much that you have no attention to the Supreme Lord? And then Dhanurdas said, I'm attracted to the beautiful eyes of my beloved, and I cannot see anything more beautiful than this. And at that point, Ramanujacharya told him, what if I show you something more beautiful than that? And then Ramanujacharya awarded a very spiritual vision to this Dhanurdas. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santaha sadaiva hrudayeshu vilokayanti. And then Dhanurdas could see extremely beautiful form of Ranganathji. And then Dhanurdas and his wife both became very great devotees of the Lord. And there are many multiple pastimes. So this is about the physical beauty of the Lord. The Lord is extremely beautiful. Venum kvananta maravinda dalaya taksham barahavatan samasitambuda sundarangam kandarpa koti kamaniya vishesha shobham govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajami. So this is the description of the beauty. And Bhagavatam is replete with the various beauty, the physical beauty of the Lord. At a struggling stage of a sadhaka, we may not be very greatly captivated by only hearing the physical beauty of the Lord. Then we can see there are many other beauties of the Lord. What is the Lord's beauty? We can see the beauty of character of the Lord. We can see when he takes a relationship, any relationship we can see. We will, focus on this relationship of the Lord and how beautifully Lord, takes care of the devotees in different rasa, differently, and how beautiful that exchange of the Lord is. So the Lord is friend. And we know in Mahabharata, there is a very famous story of Dronacharya and his very famous friend, Drupada. And how both of them were, classmates in the Gurukul. And they vowed to each other that whatever they get in the future, they will share half and half. And the way kids just vow each other the way. And then the story goes on that when Drupada became a king and Dronacharya was a very poor Brahmana, he had no cow to give milk to Ashwatthama, his son. And then Dronacharya approached Drupada just for a cow. And Drupada very heavily insulted. So Drupada did not recognize Dronacharya as a friend. Neither Dronacharya forgive Drupada being a friend. When Drupada, he neglected Dronacharya, Dronacharya also became very angry and very vicious. And he decided that I will destroy your pride. And I will create such disciples who will take away, I have come here for the cow. What to speak of cow? I will take your half the kingdom, entire kingdom, in fact. That was the plan of, the Dronacharya was. So Dronacharya was revengeful and Drupada was very, very neglectful and insulting. So this was the norm. And this is generally the norm, But one can see the friendship of the Lord. When the Lord is being visited by Sudama, very poor Brahmin, and he is coming with tattered clothes. It is said that the cloth of Sudama had more holes than the cloth. And he is extremely weak, carrying very meager gift. you know, you are at home, and whenever there is a marriage or any function like that, there is always a concept of return gift, or, you know, there is always a concept of a gift. And people will say, oh, in this particular function, they had gifted us one sari and this much, so we should also gift them this much only. So, you know, there is always a give and take, that this much is given, so this will be, you know, given in return to somebody. But now, see, Sudama, such a poor personality, and he has nothing to offer to the Lord. He's just offering one handful of chipped rice. And in return, the Lord is giving abundant mercy to Sudama. The typical description in Bhagavatam, it says that even the king of the heaven, Indra, cannot imagine the opulence of Sudama. That's how opulent Sudama was made in his, you know, in exchange for the chipped rice. That is being a friend. You know, that's how Lord Krishna is the friend. And then Lord Krishna, the way he exchanges his beautiful relationship with the devotees, like, you know, he has a very, very different relationship with Radhika, Rukmini, and Satyabhama. Radharani is, you know, the lover of Radharani, husband of Rukmini, and for Satyabhama it comes, there is a very different of rasa between the way Rukmini deals with Krishna and the way Satyabhama deals with Krishna, and Krishna in exchange deals with all of them. Very, very different. Then there is beauty of Lord being the friend. We have seen one friend, but just compare these three friends. You know, there is a Sudama, Madhubangal, and Arjun. Now, whatever was required for all of them, Krishna provided them fully. Sudama required some riches, Krishna made him extremely rich. Madhumangal was happy with the laddus, and Krishna provided laddus. And Arjuna was, you know, I mean, Arjuna was a very special friend of Krishna. When Arjuna was bewildered, Arjuna was given knowledge. When Arjuna wanted kingdom, Arjuna was given kingdom. In fact, the Khandava Prastha was made into Indraprastha by the mercy of Krishna himself. And then when Arjuna was so dear to Krishna, that when Arjuna was desiring to marry Subhadra, Krishna only devised the plan. Now we are living in an age of honor killing, where, you know, the parents and the brother, they will be very guarded, especially of the daughter and the sister. But here is the Lord who is planning abduction of his own sister for his own friend. Just see how, what a beauty of character the Lord has. You know, the Lord being, you know, the friend of Sudama, friend of Madhubangal, and friend of Arjuna. As a son, he has a very specific relationship with Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, and Devaki and Vasudev. So, where can we get such a Lord who can deal with so much of precision? You know, that's why, you know, it is said that any relationship in the material world is incomplete, because it cannot be compared with the complete relationship with the Supreme Lord. And that's why there is always a feeling of incompleteness in the material world. Because whatever the relationship one has, there will be always a sense of incompleteness, because we as a living entity, we have experienced Krishna's relationship, that complete reciprocation from the Lord. So, you know, the completely different relationship with Devaki and Yashoda, although both of them are mothers of Krishna. Completely different relationship with Vasudev and Nanda Maharaj, although the both are, you know, all of them are parents of Krishna. So this is the beauty of Krishna's relationship in the, you know, the Vatsalyaras, in the, of the devotees. And then, you know, some other personalities like Draupadi, Pandavas. For Pandava, Krishna was their charioteer, Krishna became their messenger, Krishna became their, you know, he went as a Shantidut. Krishna was washing the pots, you know, collecting the Uchistha when Rajasvi Yagya was going on. Krishna became Partha Sarathi. Krishna became the chariot driver. All types of roles Krishna is doing to maintain, you know, to reciprocate with the friendship of Draupadi and the Pandavas. Subhadra, Balaramji. So Krishna is a complete personality who has complete relationship with the devotee. And finally, we also should be aware that Krishna's relationship with all of us. In one of the very famous talks, Steve Jobs, he said very beautifully, he said, after a considerable distance, when you look back, you begin to, you know, connect the dots. Similarly, it is said, When a living entity, when a sadhaka, when we devotees, when we purify ourselves completely, and when we look back in our life, we will realize Krishna is not the personality who is, you know, there at the destination. Krishna is the personality who is walking through us, with us, all through, in the every stop in that destination. So only when we become purified and when we look back, we'll realize how did Krishna reciprocate with us, that every plan, you know, the every step, the everything that happened in our life was orchestrated by the Lord for his devotee, so that we can become eventually purified and come back to him. And this is, you know, this is how we have the beautiful relationship of Krishna. Brahmaji, he has a very beautiful prayer, he says, about the opulence of the Lord. This is comes in the 10th canto of Bhagavatam, 14th chapter, 30th verse. 10, 14, 38. Lord Brahma says, Jananta eva janantu kim bahuktaya name prabho manaso vachusho vacho vaibhavam tava gocharah. Lord Brahma says, there are people who say, I know everything about Krishna. Let them think that way. As far as I am concerned, I do not wish to speak very much about this matter. Oh my Lord, let me say this much. As far as your opulence is concerned, they are all beyond the reach of my mind, body, and words. So, you know, the opulence of the Lord, Brahmaji, who is a supremely intelligent being, is praying that it is beyond his reach. You know, we have this Brahma Vimohan Leela, where it is said that everybody was bewildered. And Acharyas give very beautiful commentary that how actually the Gopas thought that they are going with Brahmaji, but they were also bewildered because the Gopas were still there in Vrindavan. Brahmaji thought that he is taking Gopas and the calves and the cows, but even Brahma was bewildered. And everything was lying there itself for one full year, and all the Vrijavasis who were moving around in that area but could not recognize all these things, they were bewildered, and ultimately even Balaramji was bewildered. So only Krishna has this amazing potency, and this Krishna is available to us by chanting his holy names. When we chant Krishna's names, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna is available with entirety of opulence of Godhead. You know, all that Aishwaryasya, Samagrasya, Viryasya, Yashasya, Shriya, Gryana, Vairagya, everything is available in this chanting the holy names of the Lord and the books of Srila Prabhupada. And that's why we resolve ourselves to chant attentively, to read Srila Prabhupada's books, to be in the association of devotee, and hold this very powerful, you know, very precious jewel of Krishna consciousness that we have achieved. Some of you are chanting 4 rounds, 8 rounds, 12 rounds, 16 rounds. It is one of the greatest wealth in your life. And we should be, because by the lack of association, we should not give, you know, we should not give Maya a chance to let loose this beautiful jewel of Krishna consciousness to be lost in our life. So we'll conclude here. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Krishna Bhagavan ki jai. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. So we would like to extend our gratitude to His Grace Mukundanand Prabhu for very wonderfully describing on the topic the beauty aspect of Krishna. So we have come to the end of day one of the six opulences of Krishna. We like to express our heartfelt gratitude to His Grace Mukundanand Prabhu, His Grace Hare Krishnanand Prabhu, and His Grace Achyut Mohan Prabhu for coming and gracing this occasion and enlightening us on the six opulences. Today we covered three opulences, that is the fame of Krishna, the beauty of Krishna, and the strength of Krishna. And tomorrow we'll be seeing the other three aspects of Krishna's opulences. So tomorrow we have three wonderful speakers with us. We have Dr. Harivamsh Prabhu from Stanford University and currently a professor at Tata Institute of Research Foundation. And we have second, we have Anand Balram Prabhu, who is the ex-director of Cognizant. And we also have His Grace Antardeep Prabhu, who is a graduate from IIT Kharagpur and the currently serving as the chairman of Voice. So we have three wonderful speakers lined up for tomorrow's session. And we have, so I request all of y'all to please stay tuned for the next three opulences that we will be seeing tomorrow at 2:15 p.m. at the same Zoom ID. And we have also a very, very special announcement for all of y'all tomorrow. For that, all of you will have to come, of course, at 2:15 p.m. for wonderful kirtans. And thank you very much, all of y'all, for coming and joining. In case you like the session, please post your comments, questions, you know, on the chat box, on the comment box, to our speakers. And thank you very much. Good night, and hope to see all of y'all tomorrow for the six opulences of Krishna part 2 tomorrow. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.